Hello everyone, this is the Joy of Reading and welcome to a new video. Today I would like to do a book tag, precisely the middle grade book tag by Curly Reader. So let's start with the first question. What is the last middle grade book you read? The last one I read is probably The Bear's Famous Invasion of Sicily by the Italian writer Dino Buzzati, published in 1945. Buzzati was not primarily a children's author, but he happened to write this short novel and other children's novels. This book is about a group of bears who live in the mountains of Sicily. One year, these bears remain without food in winter, and so they decide to invade the Grand Duchy of Sicily, which is of course governed by men. After a long struggle, the bears manage to conquer the Grand Duchy of Sicily, and their king starts to reign upon men and bears together. And his kingdom at first is characterized by peace and well-being and justice, but eventually the bears become corrupted. On his deathbed, the king of the bears tells the other bears that they should go back to the mountains they came from. This was technically a book for children at the time, not even for middle graders, but I think the themes are very deep and complex, so I think this book can be read not only by middle graders, but also by adults, as me. It's sort of a Sicilian Animal Farm, so to say. The second question is, what is a middle grade book someone read to you as a child? So the first one that pops into my mind is The Little Prince, so Le Petit Prince, by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. This book is extremely popular in Italy, apparently more than in other countries, because I've never heard an English-speaking booktuber mention it so far. The book is about a pilot who falls in the desert with his plane and meets a young child, the little prince, who comes from another planet. And the little prince is lonely because he lives alone on his small planet, and he and the pilot form sort of a friendship until the prince makes an important decision. I remember that my mother read it to me probably end of the elementary school or beginning of the middle school. I didn't particularly appreciate it at the time because, truth be told, it's not a book for children. Despite the very simple prose, the pictures, and the fact that it apparently addresses children, I read it again more than 10 years later and I loved it. So it's a middle grade book, but not 100%. Third question. What was your favorite middle grade book as a child? Well, that's easy. The Story of a Seagull and the Cat Who Taught Her to Fly by Luis Sepúlveda. The book was quite popular at the end of the 90s, and I think I've read it maybe 20 times or so. At the beginning of the book, a female seagull called Kenga gets stuck in an oil slick. This happens in the North Sea near Hamburg in Germany. Kenga manages to get out of the slick, but she is almost dying, and she uses her last forces to fly away and land on a balcony. But this balcony already belongs to a cat, a black cat called Zorba. Kenga manages to lay an egg, and she asks Zorba not to eat the egg to protect the small seagull against dangers and to teach him or her to fly. Zorba promises and Kenga dies. And the rest of the book is about how Zorba manages to keep his word. And of course Zorba faces difficulties. It's not easy for him to, especially to teach the young seagull how to fly. But he keeps trying and he wants to keep his word. And this book really teaches a lot about commitment. Furthermore, As I read this book for the first time, I was about 8 or 9 years old. I didn't realize that something like a oil slick could happen. And it struck me. The image of this oil slick never left my mind. Question 4. What is your favorite middle grade book as an adult? Well, the very same book, Story of the Seagull and the Cat Who Taught Her to Fly. Who is your favorite middle grade author? Well, this is not an easy question. Probably my favorite one is the Italian writer Bianca Pizzorno. She has written several books with girls as protagonists. Several of them are set after the Second World War because she grew up after the Second World War herself. But there are also books set in the second part of the 20th century and even in the 19th century. So the novels cover a wide time span. And I could really identify with her female protagonists because they were curious, temperamental, stubborn. So I could really identify with them and I love everything she writes. Question 6. What middle grade book do you think should be required reading in school? I am against required reading in school. So, in my opinion, no middle grade book should be required reading in school. Question 7. What is your favorite middle grade book cover? I think I haven't any. So there were editions that I particularly enjoyed. For example, the Italian edition of Roald Dahl novels, but not a particular cover. And last question. What is your favorite middle grade book to screen adaptation? Well, I have no doubt. Matilda, 1996 movie by Danny DeVito, based on the book Matilda by Roald Dahl. The movie was a great combination of inspiring, deep, and funny, and the young girl playing the protagonist was simply great. And when I think about the book, I always imagine the characters to have the same face and gestures they had in the movie. So it's definitely my favorite. That's all for today. Thank you for listening. In my next video, I will finish reading, translating, commenting Dante's Inferno Canto 2. If you're interested, please subscribe to my channel. And you can also find me on Facebook with the same name and the same logo. Thank you for listening.